Nada still hasn't found Saber's expansion. Nada only now venturing out with his medic and marines. He's going to check out the 12 o'clock base. I'm not sure if from there he's going to go on. And I think he is actually going to go on towards the 11 o'clock base from there. Looks like he's heading for it. Saber's setting some zerglings up to defend it. Nada with a group of about a full medic and marine group, at least with at least about 10 marines and about 3 or 4 medics. Saber has got lurkers there. I don't think Nada can break this defense with lurkers and zerglings. So Saber's got that expansion well defended. Critical difference between what Yanak did last game and what Saber's doing this game. And Nada, why is they sending the SCV in first to check out the lurker positioning? And Nada coming through, he takes out one of the lurkers. He's not forced to find the second lurker. He took down some damage from his marines, but Nada brilliant with combat scan. Saber not able to get those lurkers in time, down in time. So Nada drawing first blood there in terms of damage dealt to enemy units. Saber trying to get those lurkers down to try and cut off Nada's reinforcements and at the same time cut off the retreat to the units that were committed towards that 11 o'clock expansion. But unfortunately for Saber, he did not get those lurkers down in time. Nada arriving, Nada's troops arriving just in time. The Comsat scan went off and Nada brilliantly taking out those lurkers. So both players with some excellent StarCraft right now. But I still feel Nada should be pressuring Saber a little bit more. Saber's going to be able to use a lurker later on in the game. Looks like Nada's almost ready for his push. His science facility is up. He has not produced dropships as I thought he might want to do one. I guess he just doesn't want to waste the resources on and have the time for it. But Saber is spread around the map. That being said, Saber does have lurkers and stuff for defense. So maybe a dropship isn't that great an idea that early on in the game. He's going for his push, and Nada with its standard Terran push coming now Savior's way. Saber has got a decent force of lurkers, mutilus, and zerglings up, and Saber's now getting his defilers den up, so obviously Nada's going to need to do some damage before that defilers den up, and before Saber has some defilers up. Saber now trying to counter Nada. He's going in for Nada's main, but Nada at the choke. This is going to hurt Saber big time. Saber's going to be in huge trouble now. Saber's lost a few of his mutilus and his zerglings. He should have gone to pincer Nada's main force in the middle of the map. Instead, he committed half of his troops to that attack at Nada's main, and that's gonna cost Saber a lot. But he just needs to try and buy himself some time now. Nada with those science buses isn't going to be slowed down too much. Nada's still in the middle map. Saber knows he only needs a little bit of time. That Defiler's Den was almost complete already, and maybe that's all he was trying to do. Maybe he was just trying to buy himself some time by going at Nada's choke. He surely knew that that wasn't going to be very effective. Either way, that was a gamble that did not pay off for Saber. His units, most of the units that he committed to the choke died. I think he pulled out some of the mutilus, but he still lost a fair few mutilus as well as Rings. And now Saber going for that expansion at the 9 o'clock position. So Saber really cementing his hold over the left side of the map. Nada content to Nada's push just seemed to have stalled there for a little while, and still just sitting there in the middle of the map. I don't understand what he's trying to do. I can see he's trying to maybe perhaps establish a perimeter and maybe expand himself at the 12 o'clock position. I don't think that's a good idea. I think he should have pressured Saber, because Saber's defiler stand is now up. His evolution chamber has gone up. Another evolution chamber has gone up for him, and now he's producing the defilers, and this is not good by Nada. I think he let Saber off the hook there. If he had pushed there and then, he would have been able to, I think, deal significant damage to Saber's economy and then place himself in a much more aggressive position. Nada playing a relatively defensive game compared to what I would have expected him to play. Finally, he moves out with the science vessels. He's got a couple of science vessels. Maybe he was waiting for the Irradiate. I don't know. He should have Irradiate by this point in time, I would guess. But I still think Saber is going to be in a fairly strong position to defend this, and I'm just being distracted by the stupid phone ringing in the background. I've ignored it, and whoever it is obviously doesn't realize that I do not want to talk to them right now, and I wish people would get a clue. Anyway, so Saber with the Defilers, big group of lurkers, full group of lurkers, along with a handful of Zerglings. It would be really handy if he'd managed to save those Mutilus. One of the science vessels almost gets taken out. Brilliant micro by Nada. He's pulling his troops back. He's fighting a staggered battle here. I think those defilers have gone down. Saber doesn't have swarm over most of his lurkers, so that's going to cost him a little bit. But he's managed to get in view of at least one of the tanks. He managed to take out one of the siege tanks that was seized there. One of the other siege tanks survives with D-Matrix going off. I didn't see Irradiate, so perhaps Nada has gone for D-Matrix before he's gone for Irradiate. That would not make sense to me as a tactical move. But he did manage to kill off that defiler before it could get in range and put the swarm over where Saber would have really been able to deal damage and kill off both of Nada's tanks. Saber still managed to take out one of Nada's tanks. And now Saber really spreading himself over the map, taking out that 12 o'clock position. Nada needs to start killing some of these expansions here, or this game is going to slip away from him. Once again, Nada venturing out with a large force. Saber doesn't have a defiler here. This might be trouble for Saber. Irradiate goes off on the defiler. Nada pushing forward. Saber now with the swarm. He's trying to corner Nada into that expansion. Nada getting in, going forward. And Nada's troops are in a little bit of trouble here because there were two lurkers behind the lines. Lots of skirmishes coming out. One of the science vessels is going to take it out. Nada maneuvering the science vessels. All the science vessels is going to take it out. And the marines get taken out. Brilliant by Saber. Saber with a stroke of brilliance takes out all of the science vessels as well as the medic and marine group. Great play by Saber. I'm really impressed, guys. I've got to say, that was genius. That was beautiful play by Saber. He had those two lurkers waiting. Nada's troops stopped momentarily to attack those lurkers, and Saber brought his lurkers in from behind as well. And while Nada's forces were engaged with the lurkers and the zerglings, he did perfect zerg scourge micro and took out all three of Nada's science vessels. And that's going to set Nada back a long way in this game. Saber now with The expansion advantage and Nara unable to do any real damage to Savior. He has got that 12 o'clock expansion of his own, but this game is starting to look more and more like the game between Kanata and Savior, although Nara is doing a lot better than Kanata was doing. He has been killing a few defilers. I don't think Savior will mind too much. Savior's now got that got an expansion up at the 12 o'clock position. And I'm not sure what Nara needs to really do something here. He needs to kill an expansion. He needs to, again, I think Terran players are neglecting their dropship use too much. We saw in the last game as well when Nara used the dropships versus Yarnak how effective that was. And I really think that's what he should be trying to do here. I think a couple of dropships would distract Savior. That being said, Savior seems to be prepared for it. He's got at least a lurker and a sunker in every expansion. And that is very good defense. Nara, once again, venturing forward towards that 12 o'clock expansion. Savior's pulled his troops away critically because he thinks he's going to have that Nidus up in time. And Nara, not actually going, he just pushed a little bit and pulled back. He's forced to stay in the middle of the map because he doesn't have enough troops to defend and go for expansion. If he goes for Savior's expansion, he's seen what Savior did for Kanata. He's seen that Savior is willing to commit himself. Nara with this Comsat scan, the three lurkers are already buried, more sunkens are coming up. Savior's got the Nidus Canal up, and Nara trying to try and get a position from where he can seize that expansion at the 12 o'clock position. He knows desperately that Savior is controlling most of the map and he needs to do some damage. We're just switching into Nara's first viewer. He sees Savior's coming into him with a handful of Zerglings, and Nara again with brilliant staggered micro, killing a handful of Zerglings, pulling back before the swarm goes up. A lesser Terran player might have lost a few units, not Nara, and he really is playing very near the peak of his game, though Savior, to me, just seems to be edging a little bit ahead. Nara with about 6 racks and a couple of factories. And I think those 3 science vessels he lost has really hurt him, because he would have been spamming Irradiate with those. I think he only got a couple of Irradiates off before those science vessels got taken out by Savior, so that was very costly for Nara indeed. He's built up his science vessel force again, and Nara now is building up and Nara trying to basically keep, and I've seen what Nara's trying to do here, and I realize now what he's trying to do. I guess this is what he's been trying to do all game. He's trying to keep the right side of the map, but critically Savior's taken the expansion at the 12 o'clock position, as well as the one at the 6 o'clock position, and one of those expansions at the very least should belong rightfully to Nara. So that's what is Savior's main advantage in this game, not to mention Savior's expansions are better defended than Nara's. Nara's been concentrating on holding the middle of the map while he builds up a large enough force to try and bulldoze through Savior. And Nara now sending some forces out, once again threatening that 12 o'clock expansion, trying to maybe draw Savior in one direction, trying to keep Savior busy. And I think Savior needs to go on the offensive here. I think Savior's too content for now to sit back and let Nara build up those forces. I don't think it's a good idea. I know Nara's in a strong defensive position up a ramp, but I think Savior needs to be doing something a little bit different, something a little bit more, maybe a draw, maybe a handful of mutilists to go and harass. Nara now building up defenses, and Nara actually's taken that 6 o'clock base. I thought that was going to be Savior's, but it looks like Nara's taken that 6 o'clock expansion, Savior with the 12 o'clock expansion. The map evenly divided between those two players, even though I would have thought Savior had the upper hand, but Savior's got Ultralisk now. He's got Defilers up and ready. Both players have been allowed to master their tech units. I think this was a mistake by Savior, allowing Nara to get up all of those science vessels, and now Nara making a move once again towards that 12 o'clock expansion, just using his Medic and Marines. This is something we didn't see Kanata do. Nara using the Medic and Marines to cover the science vessels. Looks like, no, I thought for a second that Plague went off over those science vessels, and it actually does look like there was Plague. Looks like Savior managed to get a Plague off on most of Nara's science vessels. That's going to hurt Nara. That's going to be painful for him. Nara just setting up a turret wall at that 6 o'clock expansion, facing Savior's base in the east to prevent Savior from coming in with a drop. Savior has got fast speed overlords, and I do think it might be possible. A drop might be a distinct possibility by Savior here. However, Nara's got turrets again in his main, and if Savior... This is exactly what I suggested Savior should do, but I'm afraid of Savior doing it now because this might cost him. He should send at least a few overlords as decoys first. I don't think he anticipates that there are going to be lots of turrets there, and Savior's going to lose a lot of units. One of the overlords at least is going to get taken down. Nara doesn't have a lot of units though. Savior now finally dropping. He's lost a couple of overlords already. I think he's able to drop most of the units. I think he lost a couple of ultralisks, unfortunately, for Savior in that first drop, and Nara bringing in the reinforcements with the Marines. Savior's just only going to be able to kill off the turrets. He's not really going to be able to do too much damage. Nara bringing back the science vessels to irradiate those three ultralisks, and he's got a large group of medic marines. So Savior's drop fails. That was an ineffective drop, and I think Savior just didn't count. He's trying to take a supply depot down. Savior managed to pick a supply depot off. He's now dropped a defiler. It's a little bit too late now for Savior to do any damage with that drop, and he managed to cast plague off as well as a swarm on those marines. But it didn't really make a difference to the game. Nara getting another army up to tech up his siege, and he's got a couple more factories building. I've got to say, Nara looks in a very strong position. He's managed to amass, by playing that defensive sort of game, he's managed to amass. Savior now battling force in the middle of the map. Nara's got a lot of science vessels. Savior's got a lot of ultralisks and zerglings. This is a classic battle, classic epic pitch battle between those two. Nara brings the science vessels to weigh in on the equation. Savior looks like he's taken off most of Nara's forces, but Nara's got reinforcements arriving quicker than Savior, and he holds on to the defense. Guys, this game is slipping away from Savior. I thought Nara, not being aggressive, turtling, was playing into Savior's hand, but by controlling the middle of the map, by keeping... And Saber now coming in with Mutilus, trying to take down a couple of science vessels. He manages to pick off one of the science vessels. The Scourge trying to take another one down. Nada with excellent micro manages to defend the science vessel. Number two of the science vessels looks like they've gotten taken out. Nada now reduced, and this is exactly what Saber needed to do. Nada at one stage looked like he had 8, 10, almost 12 science vessels, and he was really laying the hurt on Saber with them. Saber's managed to...